When I think of dirt, I think that it's going to be full of germs.
I would say I'm probably somewhere towards a conservative clean freak.
When I was a kid, it was sort of like constant vigilance against what people put in their mouth, washing hands, don't touch this, that's dirty.
I remember learning about microbes in a seventh grade science class, and they taught us that microbes were germs and that they were essentially bad for your health.
We like to keep the things that we own as clean as we can. That's why Dan is cleaning his bike. It looks much better now, but his hands don't. Now they need cleaning. Dan washes up because, for one thing, the soap and water are washing away microbes.
Microbes? Microbes. I don't think about microbes, nope.
As parents, we all just want to keep our kids safe. I don't think we ever stop worrying about them. But some of the trickiest worries are about things we can't even see.
We like to keep the things that we own as clean as we can. Dan washes up because dirty hands don't look very good.
Before the internet, that's how we learned about important issues. Have you learned anything?
Nope.
What were they trying to tell you?
Dan needs to wash his hands because his hands are dirty.
Definitely old school. So what does modern science tell us about germs and microbes?
Microbes are everywhere. They're in deep sea vents way under the sea at high pressures. They're in lakes 1,000 feet under the ice. They've been here long before we were. And they built this world as we know it and contribute to all the life forms that we see around us.
Microbes are actually part of our physiology. The way we develop, the way our organs and our systems develop in our body, depend not only on functions that are encoded or produced by our genes, they're reliant on our microbes.
There's at least as many microbes in and on us as there are human cells. They're so numerous, they outnumber the number of stars in the galaxy.
We all have around 35 to 40 trillion bacterial cells alone inside our bodies. Most of them reside in our intestine, and they play a fundamental role in how our bodies develop and how they function. Everything from producing little chemicals that your body needs, all the way through to fighting off other pathogens, other dangerous bacteria or dangerous viruses, which you would otherwise be susceptible to.
We and our microbes, it's not just two separate things. It's just like another organ that we have.
Microbes can produce chemicals which actually affect how our brains develop and even how we behave. Hungry may be a real thing. We know that microbes can play a role in diabetes, in obesity, in asthma, in food allergies.
In the last 50 years, we've seen an incredible decrease in the amount of infectious diseases, measles, mumps, tuberculosis, hepatitis. That's great. But in the same time frame, we've seen almost an equal increase in the number of autoimmune diseases, allergies, asthma, diabetes, intestinal disorders, and obesity.
My brother and sister had very severe chronic asthma, the type that does not get controlled easily. You almost have to put them in a cocoon to prevent them from getting sick. They can almost stop breathing, or you can see them changing color due to the lack of oxygen.
I see Zaire in an attack. Sometimes I can't think because I'm trying to think of what to do, and there's nothing to do other than just give him the three medications that they've given him. And if that seems not to be working, I feel scared.
I try not to think too much about the fears, but they're there.
He is 12 weeks. I want him to be healthy and grow up to be whatever he wants to be.
There's only about 100 different kinds of bacteria that actually cause bacterial infections. Yet we have thousands of different species in and on us living in our bodies. They help our brain develop, they help our gut develop, they help our immune system develop. And when you take them out of the equation, we realize this doesn't happen. Then we started to see this rise in obesity and allergies and asthma and autism and ADHD, and you know, you pick your disease.
But how could microorganisms that live in your gut affect your odds of developing asthma, which is a disease of the lungs, or diabetes, which is a blood sugar disorder? In the next 50 minutes, we're going to talk to families, researchers, and scientists to try and figure out what's harming our microbiome and what we can do to reverse this dangerous trend. But first, a quick biology primer. A microbe is basically any living thing that's too small to see without a microscope. That includes protozoa, viruses, fungi, and bacteria. Microbes are the oldest and most successful life forms on Earth, and we've evolved with them in a deeply complex symbiotic relationship. Microbes train our immune systems, help us digest our food, and even help us fight disease. Without microbes producing vitamin K, for example, our blood wouldn't coagulate, and we'd pretty much all bleed to death. Blech.
Turns out that you and I are basically genetically identical. We're 99.99% other than a chromosome, the same between us, right? And all humans are like that. What's different is they're microbes. What we're finding is that we're actually not being very good to our microbes. Ironically, our grandparents had much better microbes than we do now.
And how do we know what kind of microbes people had 100 years ago?
Mostly from the guts of World War I soldiers buried in permafrost. And even further back, from frozen Viking latrines. The microbes in these samples are totally different from what are found in modern European populations today.
In the past century or two, we really have been cleaning up the world. And there's been really drastic changes, not only in the type and the number of microbes that we get to live with, but also the consequences in our bodies.
We're missing these essential microbes that we need just to live normally.
And that leads to disease?
Yep, there's a lot of data indicating that this does. You can take mice that don't have any microbes, their brains don't develop normally, their immune system does not develop normally, their gut doesn't develop normally. And what we're now realizing is that many of these diseases have screwed up microbes, and in several cases we're showing that the screw up of microbes is actually contributing to the disease.
So what happened? If the rise of so many modern diseases stems from our kids missing microbes, the ones that our grandparents all had, where'd they go?